What is up, survivors? So patrons are probably going to see this first. This is one of the many benefits of joining Patreon, is that you get early releases of these special bonus kinds of videos. These are just things I like to do once in a while, ideas that occur to me that I want to make videos about. Again, bonus content for you guys, to show my appreciation. So I decided in this one to talk a little bit about my experience as a YouTube reactor, and some of the various things that come with the territory. Both things that I enjoy, and things that can make it super difficult. So anyone who knows a little bit about reaction channels knows that we have our fair share of challenges, mostly presented by a social media platform that doesn't exactly go out of its way to make things convenient or beneficial for its content creators. And so we'll get into the good and the bad of the biz. I'm going to list some of the perks and peeves of being a reactor, things I really enjoy and benefit from, and things that, well, not so much. So one of the perks of doing a reaction channel is being introduced to new music and broadening my horizons. Now, that might seem obvious to people, but I think some reactors just get into this kind of safe area where they don't want to challenge themselves. Like, they find their comfort zone and they stay there. Like, as one example, I've seen some channels that start reacting to, say, stand-up comedy videos, right? And when those start getting a lot of positive feedback, they just stick with that one thing. They figure they found their successful formula, they're just going to stick with it. And they never bother to go beyond that and to try and experiment with different things. For me, having nuclear reactions has done the opposite. I continue to react to more genres outside of metal, and even within metal. I always keep a nice mix of requests, new releases, new formats for videos, and I often find myself checking out bands, songs, or genres that I otherwise might never have been a fan of or been exposed to. You know, seriously, like, I've really lost count of how many bands I've become a fan of through the channel specifically. Like, when it comes to underground bands, I can mention Mara, Monochromatic Black, Gorlock, Achiavel, even major bands like Typo Negative, Nightwish. And now, one of the peeves of being a reactor is probably pretty easy to guess: dealing with blocked videos. Now, the way that YouTube works for reactors, for those who don't know, is that very often when you react to a song, you get a little copyright notice saying that, hey, your video is still up, it's totally cool, you don't have a copyright strike, but you're not going to be able to monetize this particular video. Instead, that profit is going to go to the record company. So that's kind of par for the course. That I don't mind. Patreon, after all, is the main way that I make a profit from my work, as do a lot of reactors. But what does piss me off is when I invest time and effort into making a reaction, only for it to get blocked. So when that happens, I usually have two options. One is I can mute the song and upload the reaction that way, or leave it off YouTube entirely and make it a Patreon exclusive in its original form. When that happens, I usually upload it to an alternative website like BitChute. So basically, that's one of the biggest annoyances for me. Like, if nothing of mine ever got blocked again, I'd be very happy. Now, another positive thing about doing reactions is the friendships that you make. Whether that's getting the chance to meet some of my favorite artists like Lacuna Coil and Lena from Infected Rain, and even the everyday friends that I've made, like Marchin, Rachel, Pony, Zonia, Mark, Tomas, so on and so forth. Christina, Mikkel, I can't name them all, you know, I can't list them all, but I can say that the nuclear family has really begun to earn its name, you know, since this channel started last year. And that's pretty cool to see happen. And, you know, I was talking about earning for work as a reactor, but you can't put a price on the valuable connections that I've made to people since this channel began. And so that's a major positive takeaway for me. One other annoyance for me comes in the form of little technical difficulties. Like that time when I accidentally lost an entire reaction that I filmed, or when there was a smear on the lens of my camera that reduced the video quality of one of my reaction videos. And most people probably didn't even notice or care much about that, but like for me personally, it fucked up my OCD. So it's little things like that. Like when you want your channel to run like a well-oiled machine, and the exact most irritating thing goes wrong to spoil that, it can be very frustrating. But you know, it comes with the gig, and I do think that I've been relatively lucky in terms of not having too many technical issues, but they do tend to happen once in a while, and when they do, you can't help but get annoyed by them. Another positive thing, seeing the channel grow. You know, I remember early last year when a few friends and I were celebrating the fact that I had hit 666 subscribers. Flash forward, and now we're at over 12,000 subs. So that for me is major growth. So to see the channel's following expand to a capacity that I could never have predicted when I first began, that's a major accomplishment, and it's one of the most enjoyable and empowering aspects of doing this. So can we get to 100K? That remains to be seen, but I think we can. So let's shoot for that next. And if you're new to this channel, and this is the first video you're ever watching, hit that subscribe button right now. Hit that bell if you want notifications. I promise it's worth it. There are a ton of good reactions to check out. So make sure you become a part of the nuclear family. But yeah, it's things like that that are very cool and exciting to see happen. One other peeve I have about actually filming reactions, noise and interference. Look, I've dealt with everything from internet outages to neighbors drilling next door. And I mean mechanical drilling. Get your brains out of the gutter. You know, everything from that to just dealing with the downsides of living in a city, which is, you know, having to pause in between talking because there's a loud police siren outside, or a car alarm going off, or whatever else. And then having to cut those pauses out during the video editing process. And to top it all off, I don't live alone either, so I also have to be mindful of that. I live with a roommate, and so I have to find the exact right times to film. So that's not easy to do at all, and it's probably one of the biggest hiccups or annoyances for me personally when it comes to doing reactions. Another positive, one that might not occur to some people, is developing new skills. Since starting this channel, I've become a better speaker, I've gotten better at video editing, better at designing thumbnails in Photoshop, and even more open-minded in general when it comes to music, which I guess that's not so much a skill as it is a shift in perspective, but the end result is the same, which is personal growth and evolution. And I honestly think that if you're not growing in some way on a regular basis, you're kind of missing out. So looking back and seeing how I've improved since starting this and how I continue to get better and better at what I do, that's something I can definitely be proud of. Another peeve I have is when you get that one random person who feels personally entitled to getting their song request done or getting special preference or special treatment and then acts personally wounded when you can't get back to them right away or you miss one of their comments or requests. Now, that is something that I've learned to have patience with, and especially when you're a reactor. It's just one of those things, man, that you have to take in stride and just realize that some people are like that. You can't bend over backwards for those people, and when you do get inundated with messages and requests, as a YouTuber, you can't let yourself get overwhelmed, and you should always keep your cool. But it is something that happens now and then, and it's another one of those things that just comes with the territory. Another peeve is simply not having enough time, and this is a serious one. Like, this is actually probably among the ones that bother me the most, personally, is that I so often want to accomplish so much, but only have certain time slots within a day or a week within which to do it. And this is something that I pretty much put on myself because I like to overachieve and I like to make big plans. And I honestly don't mind that at all. It's actually precisely because I enjoy doing reactions that I want to do as many as I can as often as I can. But I do work a full-time job in addition to having this channel. And as I mentioned before, there are certain interferences and distractions that mean I can't simply switch on my camera and crank out reactions whenever I like, which is kind of saddening. You know, so if I could change one negative thing when it comes to being a reactor, it would be having a living situation where I'd have more free time to just be able to film reactions whenever the mood strikes me. And finally, one other perk about being a reactor is getting noticed and recognized by people. Whether it was meeting Lakota Coyle and both Christina and Andy actually knowing me already after watching my reactions, or meeting a couple metalheads at a show that knew me from my channel, and even people online do recognize me from time to time. As someone who takes pride in what I do, it does feel nice and it does feel gratifying to be seen and appreciated by people for what I do. Like, it's a reminder that people actually value what I do and that I make an impression. And that's part of what drives me. And on top of that, it also proves to me that I'm good and consistently getting better and better at what I do. And as a good friend of mine told me a few months back, if your reactions weren't good, no one would watch them. Yeah, and that's very true. You know, that's something that I had to take a step back and recognize. So it's never wrong to appreciate your own talent and your own skill, as long as you don't let it go to your head. So, you know, it's nice having 12,000 people who appreciate what I have to offer. That's all I can say. Here's to 12,000 more, man. But that's pretty much it. I just wanted to talk about a few ups and downs about being a reactor, kind of give you guys another inside look into what I do and my personal experience with it. Again, this is one of those special bonus videos that you'll have first dibs on if you're already a member of Patreon. If you're not, it'll be linked below if you're seeing this on YouTube. Patreon.com/nuclearreactions. Consider checking it out. It's a great way to show your love and support for the channel and to become a real part of the nuclear family. All right, that's about it for this video, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Plenty more good new reactions on the way. Thank you to all my patrons, and thank you to all my non-patrons in the nuclear family as well. I appreciate all of you guys, and I'm very excited about the future for this channel. Hope you all are as well. So as usual, I will catch you all on the next one.